Hey, I'm reprinting. That's what I do after work. I print stuff, so get used to it. Here we go. The press is now working beautifully. So I'll be printing some stuff up. So awesome. This is what I'm going to print. And then I'm going to give it somewhere, I guess. So there you go. All right. I'm going to set this guy down over here. That's not the right way. Can't freaking get this right for some reason. There you go. All right, I'm printing. So I'm using a Seafoam black ink. It's, the day's really starting to catch up with me. Just now felt it. Ooh, gosh. Yeah, that'll do something to you. Goodness gracious. Ooh, 10 hours of blood, sweat, and tears in a warehouse will make you feel that. Burn. I'm sure we all wish we were feeling the burn now, considering who is our president. I know I do. I think about it a lot. Thinking about it a whole lot. Why? Couldn't you have voted Bernie Sanders? So, I think it'd be best, I'm just crank it that way, so I could show you easier. Crank, 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 crank. There we go. It is ready and Freddy. Ready, Freddy. There's the print. It's backwards. Oh, well. There's the print. Get out and play. I think I'm going to put these at Third Street Stuff. So if you want to grab them, go do it. That's going to take a couple days to dry. So just, you know, give it a couple days. And they'll be at Third Street Stuff. And if you have like a certain coffee shop, you really want to see these prints out. The free ones I'm giving out that I print at Night Market. Just put something in the comments down there. Or, I don't know, just hit me up and say, I want this at blah, 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 or yada, yada, Common Grounds or Cup of Commonwealth, something like that. Okay, there it is. I'm going to keep printing. Big ups to Ian Conley. Want to know who's watching your live viewers? Five left. See, we got David Arvantid and Ian Conley. And we got one more person. Thanks for everybody tuning in. Appreciate it. I'm going to keep printing. I use little, like, flippy, like, scraps of paper to, like, pick up the block from the press. That way you get to keep your hands clean. This is, I think, print number 4, I think. I'm already doing this wrong. Oh, well. We just got our press fixed. It was broken. Now it is fixed. I guess there's too much pressure used and it messed up the cam adjustment. I think that's what it's called. I'm not a press mechanic. I don't know these big fancy words. So it works now, that's all I care about. And the guy that fixed it didn't really charge us, and he probably could have, but he didn't. And July is get out and play month at Parks and Rec, so get out and play. Make exercise part of your day, and that's great. Also, Pokemon Go, I think it celebrates its first anniversary, because I started playing, I think, July 9th. I still remember, it was like the first week it came out, and the Arboretum was like packed full of people, and everybody was playing Pokemon Go, and it was awesome. It was a lot of fun. Now, like, I just want to see more people out in the city, you know what I mean? It's just kind of depressing sometimes when you go somewhere and there's just not a whole lot of people out. I know it's like super crazy hot today, but you know, find a shade tree and have some fun outside. That is what it's all about. Okay. Whew. I really should have, don't try this at home, folks, because 10 hours of working in a warehouse and then doing printmaking, that'll really that'll do something to you. Separates the men from the boys and the ladies from the girls and the girls from the women's. And we got us a print.
Steven, any way I could get some prints up in Boston, I'd gladly pay for them plus shipping. Honestly, love your work.
Yes, you can, Mr. Ian Conley. What prints do you want? If you could tell me, I can get them to you. If you go to my Etsy shop, etsy.com/shop/Wiggins artwork, I don't know how to, is this how you do it? I'll put it, sorry if the screen looks like there's an earthquake. I'm typing it in my Etsy shop now, and these, the ones I'm printing now, I can't sell you, but if you buy something on my Etsy shop, no, I can't do that either. If you just want to buy something on the Etsy shop, I'll send these with it. So it'll be free. So yeah, there's the Etsy.com link. And there you go. Oh, also, I don't know, I guess if you want to, if you're not already on Instagram, I know I should know everybody who is on Instagram and stuff, but it's just kind of hard for me to keep up with all that stuff. So there's my Instagram. There's the Etsy. Once I get done with some more of these, I'll show you some more stuff I have around, and you can tell me what you want. I'll ship it to you. Okay. Oh yeah. Also, I got this print. Man, pretend it's reverse. I'm sorry, man. Here. Yeah, there's this one. I'll try to get this on Etsy. I want to print a couple more of these as like a bigger edition. I just have to find this paper. So yeah, I'll get a bigger edition of these guys. I don't know what else is there to show. Go T
Look, it's a goat. He has a goatee. He's wearing a t-shirt. Goatee. Dad jokes. Dad jokes. Just like a quick idea. I just kind of got out there. Goatee. So that last one was eat your veggies. This one is eat your fruit. So you got Pac-Man, strawberry, banana. Banana's worth 5,000. I think the strawberry's like, I forgot. It's been a while since I played Pac-Man. Then the apple. Isn't there apples? I think there's apples in Pac-Man. I must have missed Pac-Man. This is Pac-Man. Just a heads up. This is Pac-Man, not Miss Pac-Man. This is the original. So, This game is rough. Like, once you get to the upper levels when you don't have any of the superpower pellets, oh my gosh. But it's fun though. It's kind of hard to find one, like a legit arcade cabinet. Also, for you gamers out there, the Evolution Fighting Game Tournament is this weekend. It's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. If you go to shoryuken.com, you can check that out. And I think the games this year are Street Fighter V, I think Mortal Kombat, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, and Tekken 7. So, yeah. Eat your fruit. I just almost impaled myself. Safety in a Pro Shop. Trying to think. What was I trying to say? Can't remember what I was going to say. If you go to my Etsy shop, this will be on there. If it's not, let me know. It's a Burger Week in Lexington, Kentucky. And I really want to go get this burger at it's next to my house. Well, not next to it, but like close. And I can bike to it from my house fairly, almost comfortably, which it's weird. So I grew up on the north side of town. Now I live on the south side of town, and it's weird, man. I always would just go to the south side of town and ride my bike all the way across town, and now I live on that side of town. It's just crazy. Anyway, blah, blah, blah. Let's get back to printing. But definitely this weekend, oh man, Evo Fighting Game Championships. And the best way to do it is, you know, get some streaming going on, doing some printmaking, and get like a little bookshelf stereo system from somewhere. If you don't have one, just like buy one at a pawn shop for like $20, something like that. Hook up your laptop to it. If you're in the studio, I guess like get a hotspot on your phone and just crank it out and watch the fireballs fly. That's what I'll be doing this weekend once I get off of work. This is print number 5. Again, this will be at Third Street Stuff. It's free. Pick it up. That's like one per person, you know what I mean? Don't grab like 10 of them. Just one per person. Let's try to be civil about these things. So get out and play. And you know, it'd be cool. Don't like take your car to go pick this up. Just like walk or ride a bike or take the bus, you know what I mean? Get outside and enjoy the sunshine. I'm getting really tired very quickly. So get out and play. Let me see. I don't know if I'm gonna start showing random prints. Eat your fruit. Oh, this one's gonna be at the Downtown Art Center. It should be up now, but it's not. So go down and see that Pam Miller Downtown Art Center in the Community City Gallery. Yeah. Let's go back to print. I was listening to an audiobook, but the last time I did that, and I'm broadcasting Facebook Live, they said it was like a copyright thing, so I'll not be doing that this time. So, yeah, I'm just going to be talking about just stuff, current events. If anybody, like, I don't know, wants to start a conversation about current events going on, let's do this the right way. It's just a little tip. I don't know if anybody printing out there. It's better just crank it one way, one direction. So I cranked it through this way. I'm going to crank it back. So that way I can crank it back the other way. Just like that. So there we go. So just in case you're wondering what I was doing, I moved the press bed so that it always goes, it ends up over here. And it makes for cleaner prints. So you don't have to worry about paper crawl. So yeah, I guess this one, I'm going to take the camera and then we're going to do like a little reveal of everything. And just so I could show you, give you like a little tour of everything. Here is, I don't know if you could see it. It's really, there's no like monitor on here. This is like our markings for where to put the pressure, right? So that way you don't use too much pressure for lino cuts. And it's about the same on both sides. And you kind of adjust it. So I kind of use the mirror to kind of... this is not the best way to do this. Okay. Here we go. So blankets are gonna go up, and then this is gonna go up. That's a newsprint. The way I like to do it is, let's see, newsprint with the registration marks of where the paper is, and then where the block should go, and then inked up block, and then paper, then newsprint, then your blankets. I use blankets. You don't have to use blankets. You can use rubber blankets. Blah, blah, blah. There you go. Finished print. Get out and play, folks. Get out and play. And like I said, I think I'm going to drop some of these off. And, oh yeah, and this is our drying rack. Lots of stuff in here. Drying. Doing this drying thing. I'll tell you what, I'm fading fast. I just worked a 10-hour shift in a warehouse, and I did very boring, repetitive work. Not trying to throw a pity party for myself, but it was very, very challenging work, and it's very difficult. Then I come in and print, I'll probably be here for another... maybe hour and a half. So I might split this up between Facebook Live and Instagram Live. Depending on the interview level. I'm trying to stay away.
Saturday, we're going to be at the Berea, not the Berea, sorry. I'm going to be in Berea teaching a class. If you want to learn how to do this, Lino Cut Workshop, sign up on Learn Berea, the Berea Learn Shops. I got a couple people signed up, and there's room for more, so come on by. I believe it is 65, I think, 70, something like that. I should know. I'm teaching the class. I should know how much that charge for it. I'm so tired. Just go to Learn Shop Berea, look for Lino Cut Relief Printmaking Workshop, and look for me, Stephen Wiggins. I will be teaching that. And it's only going to be like 3 hours. Next year, if I do it, I'm going to make sure it's longer. I do apologize, it's such a short class. But there's a print. I don't know if you could see it because there's a print. I got it going with these things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I got 7 so far. It's time to crank it in the high gear. Let's go, let's go. And I'm using a speedball ink. It's super graphic black. I'd rather quite enjoy this magical ink. This is very, very nice stuff. And I very much enjoy I think it's cool that, you know, you could Facebook Live something, you know, and then share with the whole world, and people can watch what you're doing, you know. It's kind of neat, because sometimes, you know, people can't make it to, like, an art studio, but, you know, they can get on Facebook and check it out. So there you go. We got some new folks coming in. We got Ken Farrell, Griselda, Ian Conley. Let's see. David Arvanitides, Ian Conley, and see if we can invite some friends. Just invite everybody that's on the list to watch this thing, and I hope they invite other people to watch this thing as well while I'm singing a song, cause who knows, and singing things, that's good enough. Okay, I'm gonna keep printing. Gonna crank it out. I think I'm gonna. What's it called? Like when you're in a gym, and somebody like works in a set with you or something like that. I forgot what it's called. I always tell people this, I get the worst looks. You see, now a day. Now you shouldn't after you haven't had a decent night's sleep in several years. I cannot be expected to know these information. Working, I think it is. And this burger is called the name. I love Lexington Burger Week. It's just so easy. It's so nice. It's cheap. It's just kind of fun. You just go to the restaurant. They give you a burger. You go and order it. And then the waitress gives you the food. Give them a big tip. If you're doing the Lexington Burger Week, give them a big tip, because they could charge a lot more for these burgers, but they're not. There's one place I want to get to. I've been to Athenian. No, I haven't been to Athenian Grill yet, but that's where I want to go. Oh, I know why. See, a little bit more pressure. Came out a little salty. Just a little bit. This is a Cinco de Mayo print I did. So this is going to, what's that place called? I can't think of it. Third Street Stuff. That's where I'm gonna put it. Third Street Stuff. And I'm breaking the law, breaking the law. I think I must have printed this thing like 200, 300 times. People always ask me. How long do vinyl cuts last? I mean, really, they can last as long as you keep up with them and you treat them right. They're kind of like a woman in that way. Sorry. Little joke. Little joke. Little joke. Little joke. Little joke.
Notice the spots. Notice the spots. And this always drains the battery.
Facebook, you gotta figure this out, man. If anybody wants to join me, I think I'm going to go to the smoke house, smoke shack, smoke thing. And I think, I don't know, for the next couple days, I'm going to be in here doing this. Oh, I could show you this. I'm going to turn the camera around. So, here's my setup. This roller didn't work as good as I thought it could. And this is Super Graphic Black Speedball Professional Ink. Do not walk, do not pass, go grab it. Just buy it. You spread the ink out horizontally, roll it out vertically, and then I got this trick from Todd Herzberg. He has these little like rails on the side so that when you roll it doesn't go into the block as easily. It helps keep helps against that. And so let me roll your ink gently on the slab. Merrily. Life is but phone that dropped in the ink. But that's just part of life. Sometimes your phone drops in the ink. And you just have to keep rolling. So I don't know where to put this guy. I guess is that good? So our block is inked up. I forgot to roll it through, but I'm breaking the rules. They say, yeah, this is not a good place to put this. They say, don't print when you're tired. That's not good. And I could see why. I could really see why. It's very easy to make mistakes. And this is linoleum cut. Yes, it's like a stamp. If you see somebody that does this, try not to point out that. It's printmaking, and you make out a print. Make out a printer. You make out a printer. This is a print thing you got going on. So, again, these will go down to, Third Street stuff. Also, maybe Common Grounds. I don't know. I gotta talk to these people and, I don't know. But, we'll see. He's gotta drive first. Give him, like, 2 days. What's today? Somebody tell me what today is. I don't know what today is. So, I'll just keep on gripping. Okay. I think I'm gonna print the Junebug one. Not today. Ooh, not today. It got a little bit of, well. Junebug is a print. It's a print, Junebug. Actually, you know what? I have to carve next month's night market block by the end of this week. That is a deadline I gave myself because of several different reasons. Don't fall off the table, please. I think today I'm going to get a burger because I haven't had dinner yet. And I'm going to get some fries and a salad and a drink. I will do this at that barbecue steel shack place thingy. And I'm going to also get one of those Steel City Pops. Because I've heard the good things with these. Don't fall over. Don't fall over. Ooh, that's close. So here's the print. Get out and play. Third Street stuff. Go get one. One per version. I'm growing increasingly tired. And I have to clean up all of the things. And I'm quite curious as to why I chose to make a decision that after a 10-hour shift at work, I think that would end the live show. That's the sign of fatigue. Sorry. I'm going to go because I'm very tired. And when your phone drops, that means you should leave. So I will see you guys later on. I think I'm going to carve my block later on tonight. So I'll see you later. And you can check me out here on Facebook and Wiggins Artwork on Instagram and Wiggins Artwork, I think, on Snapchat, and BG Printmakers on everything. Like, literally everything. That's where BG Printmakers is. And we have a website. We're going to be at the Makers Mellow Market next Saturday, July 22nd. That's from like 6 to 10. I'm teaching a Bria Learn Shop that same day. From 2 to 5. It's gonna be a long day. So yeah, that's what we'll be doing. So I'll see you then. Peace out. Oh, check out our art show, Impressive Prints, down at the Downtown Art Center on East Main Street on the second floor. Don't check it out just yet. Wait till this weekend. Monday. Okay, see ya.